kill me like a Hellcat.
Before this video starts, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe if you're new, and turn on post notifications so you never miss a video. In today's video, I'm showing you guys a really cool trick how to make a card shoot out of the middle of a deck. So I think I like this version better because the way I do it is pretty easy. The way most people do it is actually kind of difficult, and sometimes if you have too small of hands, it's kind of hard to do, and you have in your hands in just a difficult position. This way is super simple, it's super easy, and with practice, you'll definitely get it. So let's go ahead and get right into it. Okay, guys, so let's go ahead and just get straight into this. So what you guys are going to do is you're going to go ahead and take your deck of cards and go ahead and just give them a quick shuffle. It's completely impromptu, so a spectator could totally do this beforehand. So once the cards are shuffled, what you're going to do is just have the spectator select a card and just control this card to the top any way you want to. So in this case, they've chosen the Nine of Spades. Just control this card any way you want. I use just pretty much my favorite move to control a card. As I did a pinky pull down on the bottom card, transfer that to a thumb break just like that. I swing cut over half the cards to my other hand, and then I use this to push up, and then I got this card on the bottom here. I'm holding a break above, flush with that pack, and then I did a wrist kill so they didn't see. I dropped this card on top, push this in, so now their card is second from the top. I then did a one-handed fan with this, and then I push this in somewhere, and then just drop the one-handed fan into the middle of this pack. So, like, the card has been lost somewhere in the middle just like that. But in reality, the card is still on top. Just do anything you can to control this card to the top. Now we're going to do the part where you basically make the card jump out and catch it. Okay, so let's go ahead and learn how to do that. So, first thing you're going to do is you're going to take the card and pretty much hold it in middle grip. But what I like to do is not with two fingers, but your middle finger and your ring finger are going to be at the very end. Notice my ring finger is kind of hanging off most of the way. My ring finger is actually barely contacting the deck. Okay, my pinky is just hanging off over here to the side. And my middle finger is right here, pretty much at the very edge of the deck. You want your fingers pretty much at the very edge of the deck. In fact, if you look really closely, my ring finger is actually not even at the top of the deck. It's more of just at the very corner. Okay, so now you're going to take your finger, okay, and you're going to push down on this card just like this. So you can either A, take your finger and push down, but what I like to do is I just like to take my fingernail and push down on this card. So take my fingernail and be able to grab at the top of that card and basically pull down on it just like this. So you want to build pressure with the card. Now, once you get it down about to the top of this little, as you can see, this little stripe going across the top of the card here, you kind of want the card to about that point. You want to start dragging your finger down. Okay, so whereas your finger was just at the top of the deck, now it's going to come down the card just like that. And you're going to basically keep coming down as you're building up pressure. Notice the card is building pressure now, okay? And you're going to keep bringing your finger down till it's going to come to the end, and then it's just going to release pressure. I dropped the card. Hang on a minute. Okay, so again, you're going to come down, build pressure. It's going to come down, and then the card's going to shoot out kind of in that circular motion just like that. So that will take some practice. Just practice being able to just like that, okay? And then you'll eventually get that down. So let's go over that one more time before we move on to the next step of this. But you're just going to push down, and then your finger's going to come down, building pressure. And then the reason it's coming down this way is you notice it's coming down the sides because now it's going to go up and spin into this direct. And I dropped the card again. Okay, so now that you guys pretty much got this down, again, you're never going to have it right the first try. It's going to take practice, okay? Then whenever you get that point, now we're going to just try and show you how to make it go higher. So if you do it normally, it'll go about like that. But if you want the card to really fly, what you want to do is whenever you let go, you're going to go up with the deck, and then that card is really going to go up high, okay? So again, you're just going to practice a little bit. Now let the card get back in focus. There we go. All right, camera's back in focus. So again, what you're going to do is control any card to the top. So they're going to just select a card, and you're going to control it to the top using your favorite method. Now you're going to take the finger, hold it pretty much with your middle finger. I know I said with your ring finger, but honestly, your middle finger is mostly holding it because you want them as close to the edge as possible. So really, you're only holding it with your middle finger and thumb. But if you have small, I have pretty big fingers, so if you have smaller hands, you might want to use your ring and middle finger. It all depends on what you're more comfortable doing. But for me, since I have these pretty, I have pretty big hands, so I need to just hold it with my middle finger and thumb. So you're just going to go down, pull down on the card, and then your finger is going to get to like right here, and then it's just simply going to let go, and you're going to go up, and the card flew that way somewhere. But again, once you've controlled the card, you're just simply going to just push down on it, building pressure, and that's essentially all you're doing. I think looking at it, you magicians probably figured out exactly how I did it. But again, you're just going to push down, go up with the card a little bit, and then obviously to catch it, I mean, I'm not going to teach you guys that. If you've ever played sports before, you should know how to catch something. Just all I can really say is keep your eye on the card, because you're not going to know where it goes. Just keep your eye on the card and you will catch it, because honestly, I don't catch it every time. I don't think anyone ever will, but it's definitely super fun to do. If anyone ever asks me to do a trick, it's really simple. I just have them choose a card. It does not matter which card it is. Control it to the top using whatever method I prefer, and then just simply make the card jump out the deck. Not only is it simple once it's learned and you get it down, it's quick, it's simple, and it's really, really cool. I mean, the fact is that they think it's in the middle. If they knew it was at the top, they'd probably know how you did it. But the fact that they think it's in the middle, it just brings this whole impossibility effect to the trick that I think the spectators really do enjoy. And I love doing this move. I love shooting a card out of the deck. It's something I always wanted to do. So yeah, guys, that is pretty much the trick. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, just one more quick overview. You're simply going to control a card to the top, push down, build pressure, and it will jump out just like that. And just practice. All it takes is practice. This took me a long time to master, okay? I could do it sometimes, and sometimes I couldn't do it. This definitely does take a long time to master, where you know every single time you're going to make it jump, okay? Definitely going to take some practice, but in the end, I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. So yeah, guys, I will see you guys in the next video. Again, we're trying to hit 100 subscribers before 2021, so please do hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to share this video. Help me reach 100 subscribers. And with that, guys, I will see you guys in the next video. See you later.